fantasy is certainly a very common thing that everyone engages in. And when I'm talking about fantasy, it doesn't necessarily just have to be erotic or sexual fantasy. A lot of people daydream or fantasize about multiple things throughout the day. So maybe the perfect job that they want, or maybe like a certain house, or maybe the latest, you know, iPhone, or whatever the situation may be. And so it's completely natural that people might fantasize about sex or erotic touch or just liking someone and being with them. In fact, in some recent studies, 93% of men and 86% of women reported that they do engage in fantasy. It can be really helpful for individuals to be engaging in fantasy type thoughts on their own, as long as, again, they've got some cognitive kind of restructuring that they've done, if they have any walls or blockades around sex or sexuality, so that they aren't kind of beating themselves up later for fantasizing. So as long as they know that it's okay and they're comfortable doing that, then it's fine. Couples also can engage in fantasy together, so they can tell each other their fantasies, tell each other their desires, and it doesn't necessarily mean that they have to act on those as a couple or as individuals. Fantasy is, in its definition, a fantasy, which oftentimes is things that we might not do, or maybe that we have done and we're just thinking about in hindsight. And as long as it's done in a way that is healthy for the individual, healthy for the couple, then absolutely, it's totally natural, normal, healthy, nothing wrong with it.
At what age is it possible for people to reach orgasm, men and women?
It's a great question. So I hear this question a lot. You know, when can people orgasm? When can they kind of experience sexually, you know, positive feelings? And so what's really interesting is there are images of infants in utero, particularly male infants or infants with penises. We don't really know their gender yet, but there are images of them in utero touching their penises, fondling themselves. So one of the things that the techs that look at ultrasounds in the medical field will tell you is that oftentimes it's hard to identify male infants because their hands are usually in between their legs so much in utero that they never actually are able to see the penis. And so although we can't be certain, because certainly there is no way to get inside the mind of an infant or even really ask them any questions, there's pretty good literature to support that both babies that happen to be male and babies that happen to be female are experiencing sexual feelings, orgasmic type feelings, when they're touching their genitalia, which is a totally natural and normal thing, even for small infants and toddlers to engage in. Now, are we talking about, you know, an orgasm where a male actually like ejaculates? Well, no, certainly not in infancy. That doesn't happen until males tend to be like 12, 13 years old. But if we're talking about orgasmic feelings, there's actually, we don't really know exactly when that starts. It's as young as the person, you know, becomes curious about their own body and starts exploring. So